basically developed a new philosophy to
you have to peel them apart to do the cartridges.
Okay.
Yeah. And maybe you can use another plate for yours. Because he's got four of them here.
Mm-hmm. Well, once you get
yours,
I'll put things on you. You get
them. I don't want anybody doing any dishwashing.
Oh.
Just anything which is dirty, just put it on the dishwashing machine.
Yeah, you have a dishwasher, I see.
Yeah.
I seem to be a little bit clumsy here. Yeah, I'm not sure.
Both of us.
It was not cooperating with me, I know that. Thank you.
Yep.
People are glad they met you.
I met my dog.
Poor Huckleberry has to walk alone.
That's amazing.
Although everybody in the neighborhood knows Huckleberry.
Every?
Yeah. Every day.
Okay. Every.
Yeah.
She has all these dogs. Come over.
Hi.
Come
all with the dogs.
Nine.
Great
nine
to be here.
Every day. Oh my goodness.
Twelve
they
on Sunday. And they stay for a couple hours and play in the yard with the dog.
No.
It started, we call it puppy play. Three
puppy
years
play.
Ago, they were all puppies.
They grow much more.
And they're fuzzy. Fat. They're
but
fuzzy.
You can
they're
see that
like
they are really hard.
Yeah.
They are very hard.
But they get real
they,
big. Call
they
get what they
put kilograms of sugar.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
We're going
to
Google it.
Well, it gets to be
so
very,
it's
very
sour? It's sour?
Of what?
Bread and fruit?
No. Oh, bread. Yes, yes, in Israel.
Isn't that breadfruit?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Lleva un cetrilla, era por un baile.
We saw the second bit.
It's the Royal
pedestrian train was going to. It's going.
I never thought that this was too racist, but I just found out today.
Yeah, so you learned something today.
Oh, they're two. Well, that doesn't do it. Yeah. No, oh, that's true. It is. Yeah.
That's quite the camera, Mike.
Huh?
Shop here.
I tell you, when you have all the big jewel shops, because yeah. Mike will kill me. It's not far from here.
Oh.
I don't know whether I should tell Charlene what is this. Where you have all the best jewel shops.
Over land and trees, yonder land of fountains, growing like a breeze, can't you roll, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, Guatemala. Take me home, can't you roll?
Yeah, with a neck case.
He was deranged.
Yeah,
he was deranged.
Yeah.
On drugs too.
Oh yeah, he was
not good. He was scared. Scared me.
And that camera's scaring me. So my friend was
here. You're the
yes, in Paris.
In Spain. And in Europe.
Nice.
Yes.
Devait
plaire, hein? Yes, thank you. And la cuisine est excellente.
It's a very, here at Paris, it's an extremely famous restaurant.
Oh, because of you?
No, hola, no. It's been a long time. It's actually many writers used to come here. So, for example, even nowadays, for example, today, there are French writers who are quite famous here. There were Alexandre Jardin, the other one was Nicolas Rey, the other day I had André Makin, that is a very usual customer.
Do they sit here and enjoy you?
It depends. Usually, when I'm here, André Makin comes to see me, because we've got pretty well.
Thank you. How long have you worked here?
Here only 5 months, and before that I was working at the place of the temple. I was already used to be president.
Castles. Oh,
and there's one like.
because I can go through only with my identity card. I didn't need to, I mean, the Spanish ID.
Let's see, you're unique.
No, it is because of being European. We have this space called Schengen, which means that we can go from one country to another with a national ID without a passport.
You say Dorsey.
The Louvre.
The Louvre.
The Louvre.
The Louvre.
Thank you. more is a record. It's not a book, it's 15 pages only. Yeah, I mean, it does, yeah.
No, but I have pink tennis wristbands that, you know, that I use because my nose runs constantly. And when you're hiking, you can't just have
Kleenexes available. So the reason why we are here is because of those monuments surrounding us. The first monument that I would like to point to is on your left-hand side. It's dedicated to 19th Infantry Division. And you can see that it's made of granite stone, which is taken from Oswego concentration camp in Bavaria, liberated by 19th Infantry Division. Wow. So we can see we have a symbolic connection between D-Day and the end of the war. The monument over there on the top is dedicated to engineers on D-Day. And this is the first monument erected here just a few days after D-Day happened here on Utah Beach. But it, of course, it was redone several times during the history. Those guys had a difficult mission on June 6th. The monument over there, that looks like a monolith, is a federal monument of the United States commemorating all American soldiers fighting during the war. But it's interesting because this green area here is given in perpetuity to the United States by the village that we passed through, San Marie Dumont. So if you stand over there, you can tell if you're standing in the United States. At least you can be in the States.
Yeah.
there were only 90 men left in fighting condition.
And how many did they start out?
225. So it was a really, really fierce scene. And what you guys are about to see is just a real testament to what humans, I think, are.
Thank you.